is a sponsored stream. It's sponsored by Microsoft Azure. What we're going to be doing today is continuing the series of streams using Azure for ML. But this time, instead of using just the studio, which is what we used last time, we're going to see how Python can integrate with it. If you want to be caught up with where I am, this is in the link that I posted in chat. You can also just use exclamation Azure if you want to get caught up. And this is part one. So these things you need to do if you want to be caught up. So it's actually pretty simple. It is easiest to use with Conda, so I would recommend doing that. Said Python 3.8 is the version you're going to want to use. You know, create an environment and install Azure ML Core. Once you have that installed, create a directory where we're going to be doing this tutorial code. So once you do that, like name your workspace something. I think I called mine like tutorial. You want to put your Azure subscription ID here. Make up a resource group name. I think I also called mine tutorial. And then your region. So this you might have to look up. Like for me, of course, it's East US 2. But depending on where you are, you might need a different location. And then run this script. And it will write out all these configuration details to a JSON file. And then step two is going to be creating your compute cluster. Again, most of this should be pretty standard. I called mine tutorial cluster, but you should be able to use the vast majority of this code just as is. And once it is completely, it's run, it's good, you know, your computer hasn't caught on fire, go back to that ML Studio that you've been using, and you should be able to see your resources. So I believe I can show you mine. So you can see succeeded. Right now we have zero nodes. That's good. We don't want it sitting here using like resources while we don't have anything to deploy on it. But we're good. We've got our wonderful little compute cluster all set up and ready to go. But we are going to, let's see. How do we submit a script to our compute cluster? We need to make a new directory. I'm going to do this real quick in my command line. We need a scene. All right. And then let's see here. Here we go. We've got our source directory and they want us to have a hello.py. Oh, it's bringing me back to the early days. Okay. A control script. So this is something new. Control script allows you to run your HelloPy script in the cloud. Use the control script to control how and where your machine learning code is run. Cool. So I'm going to copy this and then I'm going to try to take a look at it line by line and see what's going on. All right. So this we've seen before. This is just taking essentially that JSON file that we made earlier with all the workspace configuration details and pulling that. So, and now we're making a new experiment. Now we're gonna run script run config. So we're gonna tell it what directory, what script, and what compute target. That seems pretty straightforward. This is interesting. So we have like, it actually reminds me a little bit of game dev, of like how you have like kind of a controlling script that's gonna manage and kind of figure out when to call and what to do with your other scripts. So let's run this. Oh, I got an error. Cool. Let's see. Why are you cranky? Bad argument. What was the bad argument? Unknown compute target. Oh, that's me. So we called this, I called my compute cluster tutorial cluster and forgot to change it here. So also let me just make this a little bit easier for all of you to see. So here, we need this to be tutorial cluster, obviously. Now let's run this again and see what happens. Looks like it ran. So it gave me a URL to follow to see, I guess, what happened, or I guess the link into our studio. While that is loading, let me show you what we got here. So you can see it's preparing it. It's getting ready to make this run. Should be all good. Like, all right, run. We have a run ID. We have the script that we fed it. That makes sense. An environment. Cool. So this all looks, this looks how it should. So let's go back to the tutorial while this is like percolating and see what we need to do next. At first, you'll see the status of preparing. Good. We didn't break everything. The first run will take 5 to 10 minutes to complete. Cool. We could hang out in the meantime. So I will pull up our studio again. We'll give it a moment to do its thing. We're gonna have our outputs here. It is preparing. Oh no, it failed. Dear friend, why did you fail? failed. Let me just rerun something. Give me one sec. Okay, so we'll see if that works. I switched something. All right, so did we fail again? No, we didn't. Well, that's hilarious because I literally just reran it, but cool, whatever. And it's completed. Let's go back to our tutorial and see what it wants us to do next. We got our hello world output. We are rulers of the universe. It worked. Isn't that great? Okay, so let's see what it's actually having us do. Let's break this down. Okay, so it's just a basic, real basic. It says it's taking it from this introductory example form. Oh, like a really basic image classifier. Okay. All right, so that's pretty basic. So we've got convolutional layer, pooling layer, another convolutional layer, some fully connected layers. So it wants this in a model.py. Okay. Let's go ahead and make that. So this is our model architecture. I'm less familiar with PyTorch, honestly, but I feel like this is pretty readable. So makes sense. Really, really basic. So now we create a training script. Well, since this is kind of like, this is a smaller font, let me copy this into code first and then, or into our editor here, and then we'll take a look where it's a little bit more readable. All right, so what are we doing? Downloading a data set. We're importing this architecture that we've defined, and we are setting it up right here. Optimizer SGD. So we are using stochastic gradient descent. All right, so this is just downloading the data. We have a forward pass and then our statistics. All right, so this is pretty straightforward. Create a file in the Azure ML. Yes, okay. So in here, we need a PyTorch, just a YAML file that is giving us, that's pretty. Our little environment details. Oh, I need torch vision. Hold on. Duh. Let's get that installed. Let's see. All right, so we're activating this environment. Cool bananas. And then we want to use our training. Oh, to download the data. That makes sense. So it looks like it wants us to make a new Python file. So this is our control. So we're following the same kind of structure we did last time, but instead of running hello world, we're grown-up coders now. And we're gonna have our little baby CNN that we're gonna run. So let's put this into larger font so we can all see it. And let's take a look. So same thing, right? This is just pulling those config details from the JSON file we made earlier. We have we're gonna make an experiment. We are going to, same thing, but this time I'm smart and I can also spell tutorial. This is fine. We've got that. We made that. We're going to run in this environment. That's also cool. I like that you can just pass like an environment YAML file to Azure. All of this actually, this is pretty straightforward. I'm not sure why I expected it to be more convoluted, but at least it's a tutorial. Let's keep that in mind. So here's the thing, right? It makes us, again, I don't get this whole environment change that they want us to do. So they want us to change environments, right? Well, if you go back and you look at this PyTorch environment, you want to know what's missing? The Azure stuff. The dependencies for Azure are entirely missing. So then when you try to run this script, is it just assuming that you're going to change back to your previous environment? Like, why are you changing environments? That doesn't, no. Why, you don't need to do, whatever. All right, so we've got a URL. That's good. That means nothing is crashed and burned yet. Pull up our studio here. All right, so it is preparing our run. And it's running. Yay, it is in progress. Train, go forth and train. All right, let's take a look at our documentation and see what we're doing next. Okay, so we've got this. I still don't see why we needed two environments, but fine. We have submitted the run. Okay, so the whole run might take 5 to 10 minutes. Environments can be registered to a workspace with this. They can be easily shared, reused, and versioned. Oh, that's kind of cool though. So you get a multiple, that's very handy. Also, curated environments that cover common machine learning scenarios. That also seems very helpful. If we look at our studio here, we can see it's completed. And if we go to our logs, we can see that our loss has been printed out here. Look at that. Look at that. That's not bad. Ooh, that's probably overfitting, but that's cool. Yep, that looks like an overfit, unless this is progress. This is probably progress, not accuracy. Because yeah, if our loss is still that, then let's see here. So it wanted us to add some more metrics. Yes, you know me, I love my metrics. This wants us to add this so we can get, let's see, get AML1 from current context, download the data. Oh, we already downloaded the data, but we want this run get context. So let me see, two more lines of code, unless it's counting, I guess it's counting that, but the current training script prints metrics to the terminal. Azure ML provides a mechanism for logging metrics with more functionality. Ah, and then here. And then we want to log things, and probably then we can pull, if that's added to, is that part of the context then? Is this run.context? Yeah, okay, get context. That makes sense then. All right. So let's see, in TrainUpPy, you can just run object from within the training script itself. That makes sense. Okay, we will rerun this, but it did say it's gonna run a little bit faster now, thankfully. And hopefully we'll be able to look at some more metrics. What do you mean you failed? Why did you fail? Why are you pooping yourself? Run is not defined. Oh, I forgot to probably import something, didn't I? It's entirely my fault. Like, why'd you fail? It's probably your fault. Yeah, I didn't. So what was the import that we're missing? It's on my other tab. That. Welp, that was maybe not the greatest. All right, that's fine though. It'll be all right. It's okay. We figured it out. Yeah, go away, run details. So not exporting to anything, export is either stopped or there is no data. That's interesting. Well, there's definitely data because we're logging it here. That's interesting. Let's take a look at this. I am just going to fully copy and paste this, make sure that I didn't miss anything. So just in case, let's see here. This should all be fine. Yep, that should be good. I'm going to run it just one more time and see if I can get those like live metrics to pop up. Okay, so it still didn't, that's interesting. It didn't export. We're just copy pasting from the tutorial. So we'll have to debug that. That's interesting. But okay, we've updated this, we submitted. Yeah, I ran into an issue. Let's see what happens. Which section are you having trouble with? Let's see. Where's our logs? We'll just let them know, you know? Let's see. Train. .py did not output logs. All right, there we go. Cool. So nevertheless, let us move right along. This shows the workflow that you can use to work with your own data. Let me just minimize the... So this, like the first time I just edited it kind of like more organically. The second time when it didn't work, I just copied this straight from the tutorial. At the end of the loop, there is a run.log. So we'll see. We'll see what goes. We'll see what they say. Maybe we missed something. Maybe we didn't. Who knows? We are going to be adding in some, all right, command line arguments. That's fine. The data path that we're giving it. So this all looks very, very similar. We're just adding in some command line arguments so that we can feed it our own data. And let's see, has used the arg parse library. Yes, thank you very much. Learning rate and momentum, blah, blah, blah. And let's see, the train.py script has been updated to use user-defined parameters, sweet. All right, so, yep, that's fine. That all works. I will just double check that is indeed our structure. Why do we need, do you see, where did they update the environment? They didn't. Why did they want us to? Okay, we already did that, so we're fine. I'm not usually one to have expensive taste with anything but electronics. Let me just make sure this all looks the same. Yeah, so this is fine. Like this is, we have a different name for it, but whatever. Let's go back to train. So we should be fine. So let's run this in the command line. Now we need to create a control script. So we need to create this new control script. Did I do it yet? I did not do it. Yes, I did. Haha. I'm prepared. So we have our control script. So let's take a look at what this is doing. We're familiar with this. We're using that JSON config. Now we also have our data store that we've uploaded our data set to. Now we're telling it, go find the data that I uploaded in the data store. And he said, what are you using for the data store? Azure. It's Azure's built-in wonderful data store. Then we have our experiment. This should all look really familiar. This is other than the data set, this data set from files line, all of this is stuff that we've done previously. So it should be pretty straightforward. Now we've done our script run config before, so this all looks fine. I did rename the compute target this time so it doesn't break. Good job, me. We're using that same environment we've been using the whole time. So a lot of this is just rehashing old stuff, but instead of having the data stored locally, we're practicing uploading it to Azure first. Let's run the thing. Let's see what happens. Let's see if I broke it. But while this is running, let's take a look at our tutorial and see what we're doing next. Oh, and then clean up resources. I do that usually after stream because that's kind of like the more boring part. But let's go back to our run. It is completed. Whoop whoop. So it has been completed. I mean, so in terms of these outputs, like these are going to look the exact same, but really what we're taking a look at here is even though we're running the same model and the same data, like we ran it locally and then we ran it in the cloud but had the data locally, and now we had both the model and both the running and the data in the cloud. So that was cool.